So welcome back students to the new session. This is for both the standards, standard 9th and 10th, chapter 2, polynomials. And this is part 4. Part 3 we had seen long back. Alright, in the previous session, we saw how to find zeros of linear polynomial and quadratic polynomial. Alright, children, now we are going to do exactly the reverse. What is that? Now zero of polynomial is given and you have to find that linear polynomial. Alright? Okay? So let's see. Find the question. Find zero of linear polynomial P of x is equal to 2x plus 3. Alright children? Here is a linear polynomial, 2x plus 3, the degree is 1. We have to find 0 of this polynomial. Do you remember how we find 0? Yes, we start with to find 0 of this polynomial P of x. Let P of x be equal to 0. You have to take the value of polynomial equal to 0. Therefore, Bolia, what is the substitution for P of x? What is P of x polynomial? 2x plus 3. Correct? That is P of x equal to 0. Are you got linear equation? Now this you have been solving since 7th standard. Alright? Chaliye. Where is the term containing x? The first term. What is the second term? 3. It is added. On other side it will subtract. So 2x is equal to minus 3. 0 minus 3 is minus 3. Now we have to get rid of 2. It multiplies x. On other side it will divide. That is how we say x is equal to minus 3 by 2. So that is the value of x. So what is the 0 of this polynomial? X equal to minus 3 by 2. Children, every linear polynomial has one and only one 0. And which is called alpha. This x ki jagah pe that 0 is minus 3 by 2. So what is the 0 of linear polynomial? Alpha. And that is minus 3 by 2. Or you can say x equal to whatever variable you have. X equal to minus 3 by 2. Okay. For quadratic polynomial there are 2 zeros. At most 2 zeros. Correct? So 2 or less than 2. So we say the zeros of quadratic polynomial are alpha and beta. Next we are going to see that. Now children, very interesting. Now what we are going to do, you know, the zero of polynomial is minus 3 by 2. The zero of linear polynomial in variable x is minus 3 by 2. Then find that polynomial. Alright, the question is this. If zero of linear polynomial in variable x is minus 3 by 2, then find that polynomial. Then find that polynomial. Children, this is going to be very interesting. Alright? Well, if a polynomial is given to you, if a linear polynomial is given to you, its 0 is minus 3 by 2 in this case. This polynomial P of x equal to 2x plus 3 cannot have 0 other than that. So it has a unique 0. Every linear polynomial has unique 0. Linear polynomial in one variable. Are you getting me, children? Alright. So if polynomial is given and if it is linear, then it has exactly one 0. But if 0 is given, only one 0 is given, and that is minus 3 by 2. So the polynomial is going to be linear. And it is said, you have to find the linear polynomial in variable x, whose 0 is minus 3 by 2. Obviously, you will say, the polynomial whose 0 is minus 3 by 2 is P of x equal to 2x plus 3. If we change the variable y, then you will say P of y is equal to 2y plus 3. If I say t, the variable is t, then you will say P of t equal to 2t plus 3, whose 0 is minus 3 by 2. Once again, pay attention. This is linear polynomial and its 0 is minus 3 by 2. Now, this is 0 of polynomial in variable x. So, which is that polynomial? Is it this? Of course, but many more than that. If minus 3 by 2 is a 0 of linear polynomial, then which is that linear polynomial? Not just this. There are infinite polynomials whose 0 can be minus 3 by 2. कोई पॉलीनोमियल एक ले लो तो उसका जीरो यही आएगा, लेकिन जीरो कोई भी ले लो तो वो इनफाइनाइट पॉलीनोमियल के जीरो हो सकते हैं। तो मतलब सर यहां इनफाइनाइट पॉलीनोमियल हमें ढूंढना है? यस, कैसे? देखो, प्लीज पे अटेंशन। नाउ आई गो रिवर्स, एक्स इक्वल टू माइनस थ्री बाई टू, यहां से यहां हमें जीरो मिला था, अब उल्टा जा रहे हैं, टेक टू ऑन दिस साइड, therefore 2 will be multiplied 2x equal to minus 3. Take 3 on this side, मुझे equal to 0 चाहिए. So 2x plus 3 equal to 0. मिल गया equal to 0? Yes, ये situation पे हम लोग आ गए, 2x plus 3 equal to 0. ये equal to 0 क्यों लिया था? Why did we take equal to 0? To find the 0. तो अब 0 में निकाल देता हूं, i.e. required polynomial is, ये जीरो निकाल दिया एंड दिस लेफ्ट हैंड साइड पे जो भी है वो हमारा पॉलीनोमियल इज p ऑफ x इज इक्वल टू 2x प्लस 3, राइट चिल्ड्रन? ऑलराइट, श्योर? सो दिस इज द पॉलीन, सर आप तो बोल रहे थे इनफाइनाइट पॉलीनोमियल्स है, है ना? ऑलराइट, लेट्स सी हाउ, रेडी? ओके चिल्ड्रन, पूरा जादू यहां है इस स्टेप में, ऑलराइट? ये आया और आपने बता दिया कि लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इज योर पॉलीनोमियल, बट हियर आई कैन मल्टीप्लाई टू ऑन बोथ साइड। इस स्टेप के बाद मैं यहां चला जाऊं, 2 इंटू 2x प्लस 3 इज इक्वल टू 0 इंटू 2, मल्टीप्लाइंग 2 ऑन बोथ साइड, तो राइट हैंड साइड तो 0 ही हुआ, लेकिन ये डिस्ट्रीब्यूट होगा, व्हाट इज दैट? 4x, देयरफॉर 4x प्लस 6 इज इक्वल टू 0, आपको नया पॉलीनोमियल मिल गया, दिस इज न्यू पॉलीनोमियल, p ऑफ x इज इक्वल टू 4x प्लस 6, ये 2x प्लस 3 था, ये सेकंड पॉलीनोमियल मिल गया, करेक्ट? यहां से स्टेप में बदल दूं, इंस्टेड ऑफ मल्टीप्लाइंग 2 ऑन बोथ साइड, इफ आई मल्टीप्लाई 3 ऑन बोथ साइड, देन 3 टाइम्स 2x प्लस 3 इज इक्वल टू 0 इनटू 3, अरे 0 इनटू 3 0, ये 0 का कमाल है, वो 0 ही रहेगा, बट ये बदल गया पॉलीनोमियल 6x प्लस 9, सो हमारा पॉलीनोमियल p ऑफ x इज इक्वल टू 6x प्लस 9, ऑलराइट? यहां से हम बदल देते हैं, चलो देखो 2x प्लस 3 आई एम मल्टीप्लाइंग हाफ ऑन बोथ साइड, सो 0 इनटू हाफ, राइट? दिस गिव्स मी 2 2 कैंसिल, सो x प्लस 3 बाय 2 इज इक्वल टू 0, सो ये हमारा पॉलीनोमियल बन गया p of x is equal to x plus 3 by 2. Now see, this is one polynomial, 1. This is second polynomial, 2. This is third, third polynomial and ye fourth polynomial. Aap waise, there are infinite real numbers, kisi bhi real number se multiply karo. Magar 0 se nahi, not with 0. Multiplying 0 on both sides, toh left hand side bhi 0 ho jayega. So you can't multiply 0. So you can multiply any real number k. K is not equal to 0. Any constant. कहने का मतलब इस step के बाद 2x plus 3 equal to 0 आया. Multiplying k on both sides. Therefore k into 2x plus 3 is equal to 0 into k. Therefore k into 2x plus 3 is equal to 0. मतलब हमारा polynomial कौन सा है? Don't say this. ऐसे मत लिखो, आप उसके आगे k लिख दो. So required polynomial is k into p of x is equal to k into 2x plus 3, where k is non-zero constant. It is not zero where k is not equal to 0. So don't simply write 2x plus 3, आपको आगे k लिखना है. Now you understood why we are writing this k. I hope you understood. समझ में आया ना why we are writing k? Alright, so हमारा linear polynomial का form ये है, standard form. ax plus b, p of x is equal to ax plus b. लेकिन जिसका जीरो अल्फा इज इक्वल टू माइनस बी अपॉन ए भी याद करो, जीरो ऑफ लीनियर पॉलीनोमियल इज माइनस बी अपॉन ए. जिसका जीरो ए माइनस बी अपॉन ए है उसका पॉलीनोमियल के इनटू ए एक्स प्लस बी, वेयर के इज नॉट इक्वल टू जीरो. आपकी समझ में आया? एनी लीनियर पॉलीनोमियल हुज जीरो अल्फा और यू कैन से एक्स या वाई व्हाटएवर वेरिएबल is minus b upon a is given by k into ax plus b. Is that clear to you children? I hope you have understood. Let's take one example. All right, one more example where you have to find zero is given and you have to find the polynomial. Are you ready? Okay. Yeah. If zero of linear polynomial in variable y is 5, all right, then find that polynomial. Okay, chaliye, here y is equal to 5, or you can say alpha is equal to 5 given. Alpha means 0. 0 of linear polynomial. Or variable y hai, to alpha ki jagah pe y likh do. Y is equal to 5. Therefore, y minus 5 is equal to 0. Ab kya multiply karoge dono side? Any real number which is not equal to 0. So that is k. Therefore, k into y minus 5 is equal to 0 into k. I.e. k into y minus 5 equal to 0. Therefore, 0 को निकाल दो तो आपको आपका polynomial मिल गया. Therefore, p of y, या you can say, therefore required polynomial p of y is equal to k into y minus 5, where k is non-zero constant, where k is not equal to 0. So, this is how you can find. Alright, children? Fine. Okay. Good. So, see you soon and we'll see how to find zeros of quadratic polynomial, and if zero, the two zeros of quadratic polynomial are given, then how to find that polynomial. All right? Till then, goodbye.